But I will say this too about COVID too. It got people started thinking about your life too. Like, get your life in order, get everything in order. You know, get yourselves a will, get yourself a trust, get some life insurance. Mm-hmm. Black people, I'm tired of supporting fish fries. I swear to God I am. Just, and you know how many fish fries you got to sell to raise $8,000? Nigga, just, let's stop it. Just be responsible. Nigga be like, fish fry, $5 a plate. Nigga, it's $10,000 to bury this nigga. How many fishes are we going to fucking fry to bury this nigga? It's 2 months. We still selling these goddamn fish. You know what I'm saying? Like, we ain't even selling catfish anymore. We selling some other shit. Don't nobody eat perch. Nobody eat perch. We up here trying to sell fish fries. Let's just get some life insurance and be responsible. Yeah. Now, I got it, but I don't tell people how much I got because I don't want my family to start looking at me different, you know, because when people see how much you're worth, that's when niggas, you know, I don't want to come home one day and my son in there just like, man, I'm short, man, I need some money. And I walk in, he go, ooh, there it go right there. There it is. Yeah. Because even in during that too, me and my son, man, we got a little closer. And one of the things I love about parenting is just like watching your child grow. My son, 31. And one of the things I love about it, and then I hate too, is like one of the, matter of fact, Royale, he was just up here. Royale got two sons, they doing well, and he brag about it. Just like, man, we all, one, he about to graduate from Howard, and the other one about to graduate from, and I'm like this, Roy, don't nobody give a fuck what your kid's doing. Because when your kid not doing well, you don't give a fuck about nobody else's child. Because I'm like this, Roy, nobody give a fuck that your kid's graduating. Nigga, go on with your bullshit. Fuck. My son don't even like school. This nigga just, I can't, this nigga, ain't, school ain't his thing. Never. Every year, elementary. This ain't my thing, daddy. Okay, well, nigga, you in the fourth grade. You don't want to wait to figure this shit out? Nigga, this, the fourth grade, son. How you know that this ain't your thing in the fourth grade? This nigga. I realized at a very young age, too. Now, most of you in here, if you have kids, you know the sticker you get to put on your car? It's like student of the month or great student. Nigga, at third grade, I was like, I'm never going to have one of them stickers, ever. This nigga going to deny me that. And my God, he did. That nigga never got one of them. Attendance was fucked up. This nigga awful. You know, then got to college. Then, daddy, you know, this ain't really my thing. Again, nigga, just, what is your thing? I don't know, daddy. I'm into music. I said, well, son, let me tell you something. If you ever find a job that you love, you'll never work a day in your life. He's like, okay. My son's a DJ. I'm like, okay. I can't say nothing because a nigga one hit away from me moving in with him, so I can't say nothing. You know what I'm saying? Because right now, I'd be like, oh, this nigga's struggling. But, you know, if the nigga go like, yo, daddy, I just got signed, Dr. Dre. My nigga, I knew you was going to make it, boy. Boy, I'm your soldier for you, nigga. Now go on pack and leave my wife and leave, move in with you, nigga, because that's what you need. You need a father in your life, nigga. That's, you know. But COVID hit and shut down everything in the Bay Area, so he couldn't DJ anymore. So he's just trying to, you know, find some work. And I was like, well, son, you know, shit's hard for everybody. I can't keep giving you money. You got to find it. This nigga calls me one day and say, Dad, I went to apply for a job. I got one. I was like, where? He's like, a dispensary. I was like, you got a job in dispensary? He's like, yeah, Dad, yeah. Found my thing, Dad. I found my thing. This nigga has been there for a year and a half. He ain't missed work one day. I asked him, how many hours do you work? He was like, I like about 70, 80 hours. I was like, nigga, that's impossible. He's like, no, I volunteer a lot, Daddy. So I went up and visited. I visited where he's working at. This nigga picture is up. This nigga has been employee of the month 7 straight times. I was like, nigga, what the fuck is this? And he was like, yo, I gave one to somebody else. I let them have it. This nigga know all the strands and everything. He'll tell you about all the stuff. And then he tell me sometimes, because we cool like that. Dad, I got this new, I want you to hit me and you sit down, get high, get, you know, chill. I'm like, okay, wait, first of all, what you talking about? He's like, this killer kush. First of all, son, the title says killer kush. I'm in my goddamn 50s. I wish I would smoke something that say killer, nigga. Just, you know. And he was, one time my son, he was like, yo, we should pop a Molly, daddy, and just chill. Nigga, I am your father. Who the fuck you think we are? We not that fucking cool, son, to be sitting here talking about we popping mollies. I'm somewhere sweating, nigga, with my shirt off. Somebody like, who that? Is that your daddy? I'm walking around, my stomach out, just, y'all good up in here? Y'all good up in here? Just, like, what is he doing? This nigga's in there. I'm doing this shit. And The kid's like, what is wrong with the old dude?